A very good morning, students of class 9. Today we'll continue our discussion history chapter 3, Jainism and Buddhism. In that we will discuss today about decline of Buddhism, means how Buddhism came to an end. First factor and cause we see is split in Buddhism. The division of Buddhism into Hinayana and Mahayana sects brought about many changes in Buddhism. Its popularity and prestige suffered. Differences had begun to surface right from the Second Buddhist Council. Hinayana and Mahayana actually were only two major sects. These were 16 other sects and each had its own followers. Means in the beginning, when Gautam Buddha founded Buddhism, only there were one. But later on, after his death, there were Hinayana and Mahayana, the two sects took place, and other 16 other the sects also took and had their own followers. Due to that, Buddhism declined. Another second point we have to see, language problem. Buddha preached in his teachings in Pali language, means he had left to Sanskrit. After his death, Sanskrit, the language of upper classes, also came to be adopted. Means when Gautam Buddha preached in local and common language, Pali language, he had explained and wrote, but after his death, Sanskrit language once again imposed, and Sanskrit language was not possible to understand for everyone. Only rich classes and upper classes people were knowing. So quite many people left Buddhism and were adopted to other religion. Third cause was the corruption in Sanghas. The monks and nuns started living a luxurious life. There was deterioration in the spiritual life. Buddhist Sanghas received patronages of the royalty and had become very rich. The monks and nuns used the riches for their personal benefit. They began to lead a worldly life. Therefore, the religious decline was not a surprise. Means monks and nuns were living. They had renounced their family life. But after the death of Buddha, all the monks and nuns, how they had left that living of that kind, and they started to live a worldly life, and whatever the riches, whatever the wealth was, that one they had used for their personal benefit, and they lived a luxurious and comfort life. That's so it became a cause of Buddhism. Fourth, reforms in Hinduism. Reforms movement in Hinduism started with full vigor once the appeal of new religion vanished. Hinduism assimilated the positive aspects of Buddhism. Even foreign invaders and settlers adopted Hinduism as their new religion. Among these are included the Shakas and the Satvahanas. Means in the some of them discontent with the Hinduism, and they converted into the Buddhism, and the Buddhism's large number of the people were converting. So seeing of these Hinduism, there were reform had been done, which was the sacrifice and then costly rituals and rites. They have removed some of the obstacles, so the quite large number of people came back to home from Buddhism to Hinduism. Plus some of the foreign believers accepted Hinduism. Shakas and Satvahanas also accepted Hinduism. So it started to decline. Another we have to see the invasion also. One cause became for the decline of Buddhism. From the 8th century AD, the Turkish invasion dealt a blow to Buddhism. The monasteries which had accumulated great wealth were looted. The invaders plundered the monasteries of Nalanda and Takshila and forced some of the monks to flee to neighboring countries like Nepal and Tibet. Means Turkish had attacked on the monasteries and they had looted it, because in the monasteries there were lots of great wealth. All the wealth had been looted by the Turkish invaders and plundered the monasteries of Nalanda and Takshila. So some of them, to escape their life, the monks and nuns flew towards the neighboring countries like Nepal and Tibet. Another we have to see end of royal patronage. Rajput rulers were warlike and could not follow the policy of Ahimsa. Besides, the kings of the Gupta period patronized temples in honor of Hindu gods and goddesses. Thus, the lack of royal patronage brought about the decline of Buddhism. In the beginning, the Buddhism got a royal patronage, means the kings also supported. Especially we see the Ashokas and others, they had supported to the Buddhism. So it had been rapidly spread and rapidly growth took place. But later on, that Rajputs, they were not liked about the Ahimsa. They did not follow about the policy of Ahimsa, and Gupta periods also the Hindu gods and goddesses had been worshipped. The gradually it came to an end. Now we see another topic that is known as the similarities between Jainism and Buddhism. The founder of the both religions, Mahavira and Gautam Buddha, had similar background. Both of them belonged to the Kshatriya clan and followed the same path. Means Gautam Buddha and Mahavira were the that Rajkumars or the prince. Their fathers were the rulers. Second, both sought the attainment of salvation, moksha, from the cycle of birth and death. See, both did not accept the Vedas, means both religion, Jainism and Buddhism, did not accept that about the Vedas. D. No, non-violence was their creed, means Ahimsa was their creed. E. Monks and nuns of Buddhism and Jainism had to renounce family life and the world. They had to lead a life of chastity, means they completely left their families. Family life they were not living, but they started to live like a sannyasi, and they get out from the home for the search of salvation or that knowledge. Now here see some dissimilarities between the Buddhism and Jainism. First, dissimilarities. Buddhism was completely a new religion in 6th century BC. And other side we see, Jainism had been founded long before Mahavira. He was the last of its Tirthankaras. We know that before the Mahavira there were 23 Tirthankaras. Mahavira was the last and 24th Tirthankara. Buddhism followed a middle path, and Jainism believed in hard penance. Buddhism spread far and wide and led to cultural evolution in India. Means Buddhism had spread beyond the India also, like Sri Lanka, Nepal, Tibet, Japan, China, Myanmar, etc. But other side we see Jainism did not spread beyond the Indian shores. Means Jainism remain in only in India. It never spread in the any other countries. It mostly remain in India only. So it territories remain limited. So students, kindly go through your lesson and kindly study the lessons about the decline of Buddhism and try to understand. Thank you so much.